Did you know that we're not supposed to use the phrase improper fractions anymore? I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and I hope that you will stick around as we investigate why you need to stop saying the phrase improper fractions and what you should say instead as we build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. Now, a few years ago, I was still using the term improper fractions, and it wasn't until I got the newest issue of Teaching Student-Centered Mathematics by John Van de Waal and his colleagues that there was a little box. It was tiny. It's like a little box on a piece on one of the pages, and it says a teaching tip. And they are encouraging us to not use the phrase improper fractions. Well, that was the first time I had heard that, but it made so much sense. Because when we say the term improper fraction, it makes kids feel like they're doing something wrong. It's not a proper way to write a fraction, when in fact, it really is a proper way. And in a lot of instances, it is actually beneficial to have it written as an improper fraction. As kids are operating with fractions, it makes it so much easier a lot of times if you are using it as an improper fraction instead of a mixed number. And as kids advance into working with slope and doing operations within algebra, they want to leave it as an improper fraction. It was actually very hard for me to just say improper fraction now because I've been doing it for so long of saying the other way. Now, what is the other way? What should we be saying instead? Well, instead of saying improper fraction, we should be calling it a fraction greater than one or just a fraction. It doesn't matter. But I honestly prefer calling it a fraction greater than one. Here's why. Think about it as kids, like if they see 5/4, and if we talk about it as, wow, you made a fraction greater than one, instead of saying, wow, that is an improper fraction, what understandings does that build in the students, right? If we are constantly calling those fractions greater than one, they start to realize that when the numerator is larger than the denominator, you have a fraction that is greater than one, and that builds some amazing fraction sense for our students. So I hope that this little short video has helped you build your mind around improper fractions and start using it as fractions greater than one as we help our students build their math minds. Have a great day.